All right, folks. Take number four. All right. Take number four at trying to get this to go right. So, anyways, welcome to Cartoon Chores. This is Steve Jennings, and I'm from Grasshorse Studios. And it isn't Cartoon Chores, it's Robot Chores. This is Robot Chores, not Cartoon Chores. Cartoon Chores is on hold for a little bit. So, anyway, here we go. We've been working on modeling this HITEC HS-645MG, or Metal Gear, servo. And so that's what we've been working on. Microsoft did an update to their software last night, and it is causing all kinds of mayhem. The webcam wasn't showing up, and then the Wacom was acting strange, and so I rebooted a few times. So I don't know what kind of insanity is afoot, but anyway, we're going to be going through and finishing up the model here. We're going to try to, okay? So anyway, here we go. In the last one, which I've now deleted, I basically showed that right here. If you look right here, this is like a little flanged raised area here, and you can see that this is where we're at right now. So, and this is, I measured this. This is 0.3 millimeters. So I now want to take this back 0.3 millimeters and then up 3 millimeters. And so I'm going to hit E to extrude. I'm going to go GX.03. Okay, take it that way. And then I'm going to select, and then I'll go E to extrude again, GZ.3. Oops. GZ.03. Okay, there's that. And now let's go through and do it down the side here. So E, escape, GY minus 0.03, E, escape, GZ 0.03. All right, we'll do the same thing here. E, escape, oh, come on, escape, GX minus 0.03, E, escape, GZ, 0.03. Cool. All right, so now we have those, and we need to do these little curves here. So we go to above, we can see that all of this curves, all of these curves are kind of concentric, right? So if we right-click one of those rings and hit Shift-S, Shift-S, cursor selected, it moves into there. And so then I can select this, we can select this, go back to 7 again, and we can do a spin. And we're going to do negative 90, and I think it's going to be 8. All right, there we go. It all lines up. Okay, groovy. AA for W, and then W4 to remove the doubles. So looks like 8 vertices were removed. This here is just a little short one. It wasn't part of the curve, it looks like. So there's that. I have the same assumption over here. So this, again, let's go to 7. 7, okay, so then Alt, right click to ring select, Shift S, cursor selected. Now, go here and here, 7, spin, 90 degrees. Now that doesn't look right. I'm going to hit Enter, AAW4. Yeah, it removed 0, see? Something's wrong there. These did not directly. So let's go back. So this is not perfectly on there correctly. And I think this one here, let me do this, E, escape, GY minus 0.03, E escape GZ 0.03, AAW4, remove two vertices, select this one and this one, 7 go above, Z, let's hit period on the number pad to go to the selection. This should be good. Spin, I'm going to spin it negative 90. See, now that looks, that hooks up. So this is off a little bit there. So somehow that got off. And it also means that we're gonna do the opposite of that. Go to the last, go to that new one we just made, because I have greater faith in it than what was going on right there. Hit Z, let's take a peek at it. Okay, cool. Now, eagle-eyed folks will say, but wait a second. Now you just made this go underneath there. Yeah, that is a dilemma. Same thing over here. So, how are we going to solve that problem? Let's go back and look at the object real quick here. So, yeah, it does. It blasts right through. If you look at this here, it blasts right through that that kind of flange, because it is true, or it's oh, I can't remember the actual term, but these are even here, and so it goes right through that flange part. So it'd be as if we would take this and push it down, and then push this down 0.3, which may be the thing to do. I suppose it's the thing to do. Tab out, tab in. So we select this and this. I think those two are probably good. This one here, and this is a mirror. And so E, escape, GZ minus 0.03 takes that down right like that. All right. Tab out, tab over here, tab into this one. Z. So we can see for sure these two X faces will go away. These two X faces go away. Z. I even think these two go away. Okay, Z. Okay, so I'm for sure seeing that. Let's put one, two edges in here. Probably right there. Let's go loop, cut, and slide. Boop. And then this looks pretty good. But then that looks like it's going through it here. Let's split the difference. Do the same thing over here. Oh, hit enter. Didn't end. Come on, rascal. There we are. And here. Cool. So this is where it gets a little bit more complicated, to saying, okay, how are you going to join those two things together? And I can tell you what we're not going to do. We're not going to do what's called a Boolean and just combine those two things, because that would be a horrendous looking geometry. So we will not be doing that. If we have to, we just may have to, is go through and double up some of this geometry through this arc through here. Maybe even, I don't want to do it through there though. Man, that was a pain in that rear end getting that to work. I'm going to ring select this, go 7, go to above. Let's look at it, and we can see that that's where these things are kind of coming in connection together. So we can now say GG and slide this down here, and that is where it is crossing with that. This is where that other... the other vertice is. And that may be the better thing to do, is to make sure that you're... Make sure that we're not messing up this. We don't want to change the geometry on this because it will change the effect of the arc and of the circle. And so this down here has to be flexible to this arc, with the exception of when something is ending. You know, we can do that because then the arc is ending, and so that's the intention is to end that. So, all right. So let's go here. Z 7, period in the number slot side, and we're going here. And we're gonna do a similar thing, GG, slide down here, and it looks like it's somewhere around here. Okay. I wonder if we should do that with this one too. I'm just going to ring select both of those, hit 7, go above, and see if... So there is the closest spot. All right. So A, B. Might not move all of them just yet. GG, move this down to here. Z. This and this, X, boop, delete that. Tab into here. Hey, that's actually kind of, that's doing something right. That's working there. Does it work over here? I'm gonna go ahead and remove those, X. Faces Z. Yeah, that's doing the right thing. I think it's time to join these two. I guess I can just Control J, I think, if I remember right. Yep, it is, hot dog. They're combined now. And so I'm gonna do this to this and do Shift S, cursor selected, ring select all this, SX 0, oops, A, ring select that, SX 0. Is this mirrored? No, it is not. SX 0. Okay. All right, so now... This is weird, but I think I had an idea. Kind of a weird one. Let's see here. I'm gonna take this. Z. Here. It doesn't really need to matter. This is just like here and here. Z. E. Do that. E, and then yeah, extrude it out. And it's way more than it needs to be extruded. Go back to here. And this goes to here. We're essentially creating, we are creating a couple triangles. Very aware of that. But this to this, Alt M, Alaska, this to this. All right. There are some, there's a try right there. And I don't want to just boop, pop it out there because then that becomes not, yeah, okay. Okay, then okay, there's that. Do the same thing here. First, let's select that, Shift S, cursor selected, ring select this, ding, ding, and S, Y, zero. This. E, escape, undo. E, actually let it come out. Ding, ding, Alt, and last. Come on. See? Now we have a few. Goofed there. That's when I moved all this over there. Pow. It. Did some dumbness. Alright, well, let's fix it. Here to here. Shift M to center. Come on. Shift S. Cursor selected. S0. And. Do it on the bottom down here too. Here to here. Oh no. Shift S, cursor selected. S, zero. That's cool. That's good. That's good. All right. So then seven. We can see that this is the symmetrical flip thing. And then, cursor selected. This one here should be over here. So E, or actually just I can do a Shift D to duplicate. I'm gonna do a Shift D, escape, enter, S, Y, minus one, and Shift S, cursor selected. I move this one and this one. To do S, Y, zero, S, X, zero, A, W, four, and it will remove those leftover vertices. All right. Well, boop. Get rid of all those. I know this is a triangle up here, so it sure wouldn't hurt to take this edge, and then just subdivide them, and pow, it adds that there. And we actually need that geometry to be able to, look at this, what's this? It might have been selected also. So, boop, F, F, F. So it looks like this can actually become a quad. What is that? I saw something weird there. There, see that? I know what it is. It's rhetorical. What is that? So there's also some over here that do that. Z. Do. I don't like this up here. I can't add there, but can I subtract it down here? Well, if I subtract, move this down here, then there's a triangle down here. Move it this way, there's a triangle down here. We're not going to change the amount of vertices going around down here. So, and I don't like that these are not evenly spaced throughout here. Try and solve some of those problems right off the bat. So Shift S, cursor selected. Select this one. E, escape. S, zero. We're going to make that an edge now. Okay, there's that. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Select that. Now Z, go to here, you can see where those are supposed to be at. Shift S, cursor selected. Z. All that. Oh, I screwed up on this side too. SY0. Shift S, cursor selected. And honestly, I guess I'll just delete this half and flip it. But then that won't work because we now have unique non-symmetrical data on this. W4, yep, remove two vertices, so that's cool. So as we go through, it should be removing a vertice every single time we do this. Z, go back here, come on. Shift S, cursor selected. Z, Alt, Edge select, boop, boop, boop. SY0. Oh, be careful down here. I think I actually want this one down here. Oops, I don't. And yeah, we don't want it over here like that, so. All right. It's got two more to go. But this is, you know, it's one of those things that I want my geometry to be clean as possible, as clean as I can make it, as simple as I can make it. One more. Okay, all right, AW4, Control S, cool. Well, it looks a lot cleaner there now. Not perfect in how it does that, but that's cool. Still don't know how we're gonna deal with this up here. This is now, this is a triangle here. Boop, boop. Now this is a quad. If you split this, that would be non-manifold up there, so we can't do that. Non-manifold means when there's five vertices, or four or more vertices. That's kind of funky. I think that probably, this goes SY0. Let's move that back there. Solve some easy problems first. Let that other stuff just kind of gel a little bit. Shift S cursor. We've got slide. All right, SX0. Let's move that there. This and this. Cursor selected. SX0. Face. Yeah, probably going to run some drop some verticals down through here. Whoop. I don't know if I like how I did all of that, what I just did there, or not. I'm gonna go back and, before I go through and add all those in there again, let's pull those out. That's all it's gonna let me do. All right, so then, pull this X face. I'll pull this one X face. And so basically, I'm seeing from here, at least to here, those could be more evenly spaced. So let's go here, select Shift S, and then boop, boop, boop. SX 0, AW 4, get removed 63 vertices. So there is, between these two, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm going to do a loop cut and slide with 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. There we go. Now, I don't know how I'm going to like it. I may not. Honestly, it doesn't bother me that bad. I think this one here is the center of axis, so I don't want to move this one because it's the center of axis for this arc. But this one, I don't even remember what that is. You may even pull it, but that's okay. I mean, heck. I know it's the center of axis, but big whoop. Let's just even these out a little bit here. I can certainly see over here too. I actually think it might be more like this. I'll go ahead and just make these tries because I think I'm going to bisect them. Okay. don't know if that's a good idea or not. I don't think it actually is. But we can do this. Subdivide that. Subdivide that. Go here. And now, F. We may have something. F. F. I'm getting an idea. I don't think it's a good. I don't know if it's a good one or not, but we'll see. I know it's a try there, I know it's a try here, but I just wondered if some of these rascally tries might work out a little bit better with this kind of layout. This is a non-planar. It's slowly getting there. So this to this be an F. This to this is an F. This to this is an F. A face. These are faces. That's a quad. K. Try. There's four triangles right there. That ought to work. Somehow, there's that many triangles. There's a triangle, 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 triangle. If there are multiple triangles next to each other, you can always combine those. But the challenge here is that this one can't, you know, they're just not... They're very close, but they're not quite there. And there's also like three tries over here. This is a quad. Like I did over here, I could break it into a... Something like that. this a try. It could be broken too. Okay. That pinches in there now, doesn't it? How weird that looks. Let's take this, Shift S, cursor selected, select this, SX 0. Oop, it didn't. It's just a optical illusion, I guess. This probably needs to come out this way a little bit, but not gonna worry about it. At least not yet. Ooh. Strangeness right there. I hate all of that. All right, I don't hate this. And this is like passable. This is not. Trying to tidy it up a little bit, see if it makes it look any better. This is not cool here. See that it's actually folding over on itself here because this vertice is in between this one and this one. So it's trying to like double back and over. And so even though it's still flat, it's doing it on top of itself. And you don't want to have that. You don't want to have it pinching like that. if I like this or not. Just trying it. I'm making this all way too hard. I'm gonna control S, save. Let's do control S. I'm gonna try. I'm just gonna dump some of this geometry and just scale it all into there and just make it quads and see if that just makes it look better. So I can take this one here, shift S, cursor selected, and just start taking these in. Just dump them. S0, AAW4, A, and then do the same thing here. Maybe not with that one, but here. S0. Okay. Quad, quad, quad. Try, try. One triangle left, right there. Oops. Right here. Trying to get this triangle maybe over to here, because we know there's three triangles right here, and if you can somehow get those up to there, I don't know. All right, we're going to punt and leave it like that for now. Maybe come up with a better idea, who knows. All right, this one for sure we're going to have to deal with making a denser aspect of the mesh go into less dense. Do here. We have that in there. This doesn't look terrible here. Doesn't look great here. So we could come in and run it around kind of like that a little bit. Problem is you get too close to this and it has could have some challenges, but 7. Z. Boop, do that. Shift S, cursor selected, Z. Go up here. SX 0, SY 0. SX 0. Last AAW 4. Okay. So there's this. So SY 0. I like how this looks a whole lot better than I do over here. I know it's a different scenario, but this is looking a lot more tighter. Yeah, there's all this kind of mayhem through here still, but we'll get to it. I don't know if I should need to go there, if I need to go there. That looks right. Introduced a quad there. Yep, I know. Probably the easiest thing to do is take this and go here to here, and then just make that a run it there. But we're also going to run this in, so look at that. That's a shocker. Still have these two tries. Now that I pulled that darn, I'm like, I don't need that origin anymore. I go, boy, it should be handy to have it. I think I can probably go to here, and that's pretty close enough. I know it was a little bit more this way, but now I'm looking at it. I'd like to go like here to here to here. Let's hit 7. Z, period. Okay, that's right, 7. And Z. I'm going to hit E to extrude, and then scale out. Scale out to, like, let's say there. Back to Z. And some of this here we can just pull back now. X faces, because we have that. A. Control N to flip normals. It looks like these are not on the plane, so cursor selected. Go across that front edge. SC0. Okay. So now this to this. I know it still has those, but I just like that better. I have a footing there. Could it have gone over here and run that around to here? I don't know. Maybe. But. That is the weirdest. I mean, this one, yes, this one did work. This does work. This one does not. So I'll just move that to here. That makes that a triangle. A weird shape here. That's the last. That's the last. That is a triangle still. Oh, duh. Da 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 da. Let's do this. Bink, bink, bink. Merge center. Merge. Merge. And this creates that there. F. Yuck. All right. Okay. All right. So those are there for the time being. I'm going to use them to merge to. Yeah, I kind of see something here, maybe. I don't know. X faces. None of those can be dissolved down the way. Rats. I for sure see that we could move this to here, like that, right? And then this is a face right there. It is a quad. I mean, it's technically okay. Is it aesthetically okay? I don't know if I feel that way. All right, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. So hope you enjoyed it. Okay. I'm gonna have to take a little bit of a break. Okay. All right, well, thank you very much for watching Robot Chores, and we'll get there. It's really close. I just think it's gonna be one little noodle thing, and that's it. And then we'll go from there. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. Take care.